This is a journey in space and time, to a world born of fire and ice. A world shaped by the collective soul of its people. The Neva gave us Leningrad, Peter the Great's timeless city. Leningrad gave us Pushkin. I love thee, city of Peter's making. I love thy harmonies austere, Neva's sovereign waters, thy traceried iron gates. Everywhere, ceilings become the lofty vault of heaven. Soaring above czars and czarinas, Boris Godunov, Michael Romanov, Peter the Great, the Empress Elizabeth, Catherine the Great. The czars fell, but did not vanish. The worker state preserved their imperial splendors. Today's Leningrad, suspended between yesterday and tomorrow. Catherine the Great had pleasure gardens, pavilions, palaces of marble, amber, malachite, crystal, gold, and Chinese silk, and an art museum, her Hermitage. Rembrandt, Caravaggio, Bernini, Tiepolo, Canaletto, Rastrelli, Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo. Leningrad lives its summer life with sport and song and white nights. Summer sun of the north is a lamp hung high. The city lives in its golden glow where sunset and dawn meet and pass. The bells of old Rostov Veliki, the great singing clocks of earth and heaven, pealed over fields and villages, marking time from dawn to midnight, from Easter to Christmas to the New Year. Thank you. Holy Mother Moscow. Every stone, every tower holds the lore of the ages. The domes of St. Basil's, like hot air balloons, striped and swirled and faceted, tethered to the cobblestones of Red Square for 400 years. The great metro stations, called palaces of the people, bring beauty to everyday life. One of Moscow's oldest and newest gathering places, the Arbat, where music and fantasy reign. Gorky Park. In Tsarist times, it was a garden, a favored resort of Muscovites. It became the first Soviet park of culture and rest. Boris Godunov was acclaimed Tsar at Novodevichy Monastery, the resting place of artists, poets, scientists, cosmonauts, statesmen. Heroes of stone and marble and bronze. Our fallen stand sentry on life, sang the bard Vysotsky. Beneath the vaults of the Kremlin cathedrals, The Tsars worshipped the god who gave them divine and absolute authority on Earth. Harnessed in a troika, the horses fan out. A gated trinity. The soul of Russia becomes visible in icons and in the faces of the people, in the warmth of feasting, family, and fellowship. The brightest gem in the golden ring of medieval citadels around Moscow was Zagorsk, with its great loopholed walls. It withstood sieges from the Mongol horde to the missionaries of Marxism.
Так вот, дорогие братья и сестры, будем молиться! День и ночь за мир во всем мире.
Before the sanctuary marks the boundary between earth and heaven. Its royal door closes on the domain where no woman, not even an empress, may enter. Thank you.
4. Раз, два, три, четыре. Руки перед грудью. Раз, два, три, четыре. Раз, два, три, четыре. Раз, два, три, четыре. Два, три, четыре.
Folk tales and fairy tales of the grandmothers find life on the puppet stage. Winter revels call forth comrades from the pagan past. Grandfather Frost, the snow maiden, child of the winter. The bear, who was born human, but made the forest his domain. To Lenin's children, Moscow is the center of the universe, the place where the world began. The glass-roofed arcades of GUM, a century-old shopper's mecca.
нету.
Its galleries are a microcosm of Moscow life. Swan Lake, a fable of the hunter and the hunted, the court and the forest, good and evil. Red Square, Krasnaya Ploshed. Krasnaya means red, but it also meant beautiful. For three centuries before the Bolsheviks raised the blazing red stars on the Kremlin towers. Set loose birds with wishes for long life to overtake the wedding. For life, too, is only the dissolving of ourselves in the selves of all others. Russia's spirit of tradition is more than a love of celebration. It is the legacy of a journey through time that continues on with each generation.
Традиции молодоженов родители встречают хлебом с солью.